Hello. In this video, I'm going to introduce the sanskritdata.schema package to you. Now, more specifically, I'm going to introduce the books package. Now, what we try to do here with this, with the various JSON schemata represented defined in this package, is to represent a book, any given book, in a database using JSON objects. So that's the intention. So how do we do that? For that, I will open this mind map which is linked here, which I've already opened in a new window. Let me just refresh it, and we will see. Before that, let's look at an example book. So this is an example of a book. It is Jayadaman, a book on Tendus. And you will see that it has these many pages, 258 pages, which can be categorized into different parts. For example, you look at the contents here, that's what they've done. And within each page, in fact, you can still make out subparts. For example, there's one section here which includes corrections, and there is another section here which indicate additions. And similarly, there are many paragraphs in this page. So we want to represent the structure and the contents of this book inside a database using JSON objects. How do we do that? The way we do it in this particular package is to represent the entire book using a graph. Let us say you have a book. You can represent that book using a book portion object. So for this book, Jayadaman, I will have a book portion object with certain properties. So what will those properties be? Let us see. So if you look at book portion JSON schema, I have defined all these properties which it can contain. So what it will contain in this case is that the portion class will be book, and that there will be a title which will say Jayadaman, and there will be authors which will probably say Velankar or something. So that's what this particular book, that's how this book object is represented. Now what we have is just the title and author and so on, publication details of the book, but we don't have its chapters. So we naturally divide this book into several chapters, and the chapters can each be represented using book portion objects, except this time the portion class will be chapter inside the corresponding book portion object. How do we know that this book portion object, which represents a given chapter, belongs to Jayadaman and not, let us say, some novel by Robin Cook? It is because of this edge here between these two objects. So if you look at the book portion object, there is something called targets. Targets, because book portion happens to be a subclass of a JSON object with target class. So any such object, whether it is a book portion or an annotation or anything, will have a target field. And what will the target field contain? It will contain, this is the target field, it will contain something called a container ID, which is nothing but the database ID of the book portion of which it is a part. For example, in our particular example, the first chapter of Jayadaman will have the target field set to point to the Jayadaman book object. Similarly, some given chapter of Jayadaman may contain some verses. Let me open a random page and I'll soon find some verses. For example, here it could be that Shashthodhyaya, the sixth chapter, can be separated into these different verses. Verse number 1, verse number 2, verse number 3. Each of these also I may want to represent separately, even though I may have represented the page separately already. So I may have a book portion for a page object. Let us say I have this book portion here. Now below that, let us say, I have not shown it yet, but imagine that I have a book portion for page. Within that I can say, I can have many different verses. So I can have many different book portions representing verses. And I can make finer divisions. I can have book portion objects for half verses as represented here. And so I have shown you how I can represent the entire contents of any given book, whether it is an image book or a text based book. For example, what you would see in this documentation, it can be considered a book and it can be represented using this type of graph. Ultimately, for example, if I have a page, I will have the property base data set to image, and I will have the path set to some image identifier, which will correspond to the image inside this particular page. Now, this being the case, how do I order? Now, you know, I told you in our running example that a book contains many book portions representing chapters. How do I make sure that how do I get all the chapters within a book? I take a book and I ask for all the child nodes inside the tree representing this book. So any book can be represented by such a tree. I will ask for all the children of this book object with the portion class being chapter, and I will get a list of all the children, chapter 1, chapter 2 and chapter 3 and so on, where I will get different book portion objects. Now these book portion objects, how do I order them? How do I know which is chapter 1, which is chapter 2 and which is chapter 3 and so on? For that, of course, I will rely on title. I can set title to be any string. If you order all these chapter book portion objects by title, you know how to order the chapters. And this is how we represent any given book using book portion objects. And suppose, what if, now I told you what we do in case of image book. I mean, each page is represented by an image. I told you we just set the base data to be image and we set the path to point to the image file. What if it is a text we have? Well, there we just set the curated content field to be anything, any text, while specifying the language and encoding as necessary. I hope this screencast was recorded properly, and I'll stop here.